Every American can be proud of George Zell's Cleveland Orchestra, which has been acclaimed everywhere as one of the world's greatest. Normally, Maestro Zell avoids interviews. He prefers to let music speak for him. But he's been persuaded to comment briefly for audition. Afterward, he will speak again, this time through music, in a part of Mozart's Symphony No. 33.
Well, I'm a very bad advocate of my orchestra. All I can do with it is make music and leave the talking to the others. It is a large orchestra with a very considerable power output of sound, but at the same time, they play like a string quartet. In other words, they listen to each other. They don't just play their parts and follow the beat, but they follow the music and follow, while they are playing with their ears, the other voices in the orchestra. You can't claim that every member of the Cleveland Orchestra is the equal or the superior of anybody in any other orchestra. That would be ridiculous. What distinguishes this orchestra is a fantastic homogeneity of style, of approach, and a fantastic awareness of the most important aspects of music making, which are so often overlooked. Very often people speak about the sound of an orchestra. Well, the sound is just one aspect, and sometimes not even the primary aspect. It can be the secondary aspect. It can be the result of something else. But show me the lay people who will talk about a soloist or about an orchestra and mention articulation and phrasing, which is so much more important than anything else, because it means absolutely the delivery of the music for the proper understanding on the part of the listener. We try to have a different sound for every type of music we play. Actually, you may be interested in knowing that we are the only orchestra, apart from some French orchestras, in America or in Europe, carrying the instruments the composers call for. For instance, we have a pair of French cornets, and if a score calls for two trumpets and two cornets, we play two trumpets and two cornets and not four trumpets as every other orchestra in the world. We have a set of three German rotary valve trumpets, which we use in Bruckner symphonies and other works where this particular mellower high brass sound is required. We boast of having an alto trombone, which is almost obsolete, but which we use where it is called for. So I try to have every composer represented the way he directs us to represent him. So there you are.